How's it going, everyone, and welcome to another MetaZoo video here on Channel Fireball. My name is Kel, also known as Red Zone Rogue, if you can see it on the playmat. And today, we're going to be talking about some MetaZoo. Normally, I talk about Flesh and Blood, but I do like MetaZoo as well. I like it as a very fun, goofy kind of game. Think of it kind of like a Magic Unset. I think it's just kind of like goofy and charming. And so we're gonna open this box of Nightfall. This is one of the newest sets. It is very Halloween themed, so it's also very, very timely for the time of this video. Once again, my name is Kel, also known as Red Zone Rogue. I have a YouTube channel. Mostly I talk about Flesh and Blood. Sometimes I talk about other indie card games as well. So let's get on with this MetaZoo box opening. I really don't know a ton about this set. I'll be completely honest here. I don't know a ton about this set. So there's gonna be a lot of cards that I haven't seen. So this is gonna be fun. I'm going in blind. I do know this booster box is like glow in the dark. And I do like it's kind of like textured. Interesting. I do like the themes here. As you can tell, my own custom official MetaZoo mat is very like spooky themed, and I like the spooky ones. So yeah, this is gonna be fun. I'm not sure what to expect, to be completely honest. Not sure what to expect. The packs themselves are already so much different than Cryptid Nation. The Cryptid Nation packs felt a little bit, I don't know how to put it. Different? Well, so let's see what would be the best way to open these packs. Can I just, oh yeah, you can just pull it like that. All right. These are immediately easier to open. And we probably want to do a little quick old zoom on in here. We have Air Rod. So this is a uncommon card. It's an alien. So every beastie in MetaZoo is a cryptid. So like a Mothman, Jersey Devil, Loch Ness Monster kind of stuff. This is a Wunk. Wunk. This is a possession spell. That's pretty cool. Oh my god, what is this? Kinderhook Blob. Yo, look at this chunky boy. His brain in a jar is uncommon. You can tell the uncommon on the top here, if it's a silver, if we can get that back in focus. That's a silver uncommon. We have a Spectre Moose, you know, good old ghost moose. We have Nightshade, a good old poison flower. This is a reverse holo headless nun. So I'm gonna just put all the holos in one spot. All the reverse holos. Oh, interesting. So the first set, you always had a holo, but you didn't always have a rare, because sometimes the holo always took up the rare slot. So it looks like this time you can also have a rare in addition to the holo. So the reverse holo, headless nun, put that here. This is a rare. Look at this fuzzy dude. Momo, Tuper Spellbook. This is a rare. Stinky Punch. Uh-oh, stinky. And then we have a token. They're doing a lot of interesting stuff here. Okay, cool. So we got the Momo, put the regular rare there. This like kind of cool spider token. We have a Swamp, and then a Forest Aura. I dig it. They definitely changed the borders too. So I do like how they're updating the frames and that kind of stuff. What I'm really hoping for in this set, and like I said, I don't know a ton about the set, is a lot more removal and board wipes, because the first set could get very grindy. This is a Omnicook. All right, it looks like a alien dude. This is a spider dude, Lufterlang. Smokescreen. We have a Tribe Trade, a Banish. This is a Earth's Binding. Destroy Terra. So I've got a Piazza Bird back there. This is a Destroy Terra Pigeon Arena. I still want more like destroy, like dude, like minions. This is a Boil Over. Look at the nice foiling on that. I like the Piazza Bird and the frog in the background. So that is a foil. Oh, double Boil Over pack. All right, we'll put the holo down there. We'll put the regular one up here. This is a Dynamite token. What? Snowing. And then I do like the Creepy Spirit Aura quite a bit. Yeah, This is fun. So this is what I like about MetaZoo, right? I know people are gonna be out there watching this and they're gonna be like, I know MetaZoo's expensive. I know, but it's, if it wasn't so expensive, I would like more people to get their hands on this if they like this goofy kind of stuff. Because I think this goofy kind of stuff is a lot of fun. This is a Smoky Spirits Tribe trade. I think a lot of like, that's Goku. You can't tell me that's not Goku. He has Super Saiyan hair and then like an aura. I know his name's like Sam Sinclair, but it's also Goku. We have a Torrential River, Veggie Man. It looks like Salad Fingers. We have a The Red Ghost. Yo, that looks sick. Look at that. He's just riding this goofy thing. Oh, this is, once again, this is what I like. So, I really hope for a time where, you know, anyone can get their hands on MetaZoo and it's not a super expensive thing. And all the people who like this goofy stuff can just enjoy the goofy stuff. This is another boil over. You can have three in your deck, so that's pretty cool. What is this? Nameless token. That dude is, boosh. We have a lightning aura and some fog. That dude's having a bad day. Bad day. Yeah, this is a fun set. I love going into this kind of stuff blind, so I can have like, you know, the first experience, same experience. What is this? Absorb aura, you just, oh. We have a Luster Fang, a Pyre, that is dark, dude, that is brutal. Trinity Amulet, this is a Bursting Spiderlings, gross. Simultaneous Bioluminescence. That's the name of that. I got there. Oh, the vampire. Vampire Mercy Brown. Dude, I like the vampire lady. Ooh, Wendigo. Yo, I think it's a holo Wendigo. Yo, Wendigo, let's go. This is one of my favorites for the set. I mean, I got the Wendigo here. I like the Wendigo. Wendigo's cool. It's a one per spellbook. I also like the one per spellbook ones because if you get it, you're like, I got it. I don't need another one. This is a Hope Diamond, that's pretty cool. It's a one per spellbook Hope Diamond. We have a, it's just a tentacle. That is a massive tentacle if that is up to scale. Then another forest, look at the little jabronis. And a flame aura. I know Cryptid Nation had box toppers. I did not see a box topper here. I wonder if it's on the bottom of the box. Once again, I don't know much about these. The wrappers are very interesting. They feel like tin foil almost. This is Aura Prowess. It looks like Cat's Cradle or something like that. We have a Nightmare. Gets a plus one for each swamp you control. We have a Familiar. That is a weird looking familiar. Tribal Warcry. Blah, blah. It's another just blah, blah. Feign Death. I buy it. The Werewolf of Defiance. That's kind of cool looking. Destroy Terra. Ooh, what is this? Full Holo. Frank Shaw's Gargoyle. That's kind of cool. I dig it. We have another The Red Ghost. He's just living his best life riding that dude. Dynamite Island and Light Aura. Interesting. But yeah, I think the biggest problems from the first set are the games are way too grindy. And adding the tempo advantage is like almost impossible to overcome. We have this Axe Handle Hound. So they need more removal. He's got a big old shiny red butt. Nappa Rebobs. Yep, Rebobs. Fu Follet. So Fire Spirit, maybe? Tribe Trade. Got a gross bursting spiderlings. The Purple Blob of Philadelphia. Dampen. This is, Flood the Earth. I think this is one of the removal cards that I've heard about, but I have not seen or read. So I think this is a good one. I think this is a good board wipe. Definitely need more board wipes in the game. This is Stalactites. Just beware, man. Zombie Token. I actually kind of like that Zombie Token. Lake and a Frost Aura. We should speed this up a little bit. We have so many more packs. We barely started, No, but this is fun. This is, look at that. That is not good. Look at that. It's like some damage on the card. Blessed, hashtag blessed. Another nightmare, Sam's Holy Water. I like this one, Halloween Ghost Sheet. This is just a gross blob dude. Crystallized Light, Witch's Lightning, Dark Watchers. Oh, this is another, is this a reverse holo? This looks awesome in reverse because it looks like the water is like all sparkly. Dark Watchers, huh? Three per spellbook. Beast the Alien. So I guess I'll put the reverse. This is a rare. I'll put the reverse rare there. We have Born from the Earth, little dude. Stained Glass Token. That's kind of cool. Yeah, look at this. It looks like the printer just like cha-chunk right over that. Or rather the other way, cha-chunk back over the top. Glad that wasn't on any like cool shiny cards at least. That would be a big bummer. Oh no. Oh no, why is this one difficult to open? They were easy before. Oh no. Okay. Well, you know what? I figured it out. We got there. We got there. This one is just another like blah. It's Krabby Patty. Wallowa Lake Crustacean. Alright. Another pyre, that's brutal. Excavation, Graveyard's Mud. This is another Earth Binding. Zombie Apocalypse. I love it. I love that. This is great. We have a Dover Demon. Okay, so this is a reverse holo for sure. Reverse holo uncommon. And then, Dover Demon looks like an alien, man. So we have a Wood Devil of Ku's Country. I really like all of the like local folklore kind of stuff. That's one of my favorite parts about MetaZoos. You get to look at all the cool like local folklore, and you can see all of the different stuff around the U.S. Currently, it is U.S. only, I believe, and they plan to expand that out into like Japan and Europe and all of that kind of stuff eventually. So we have another gross bug, another red butts possession. I like the art on that card. Excavation. We have a Jack-O-Lantern Bomb. Please don't do that. Werewolf of Defiance. Nightshade. Oh, this is a reverse holo. Wood Devil of Ku's Country. Put that there. This is a Twin Meteor. It's cool that you can get double rares per pack. So you can actually, I think it's probably easier to get a lot of rares here. Twin Meteor. You may fatigue this page at any time. Oh, it's like an item. Like it stays on the field. To generate an aura and a fire aura, you may not control more than two artifact essence in the arena. Oh, interesting. Oh, it's like a double mana rock kind of thing. If you have not played MetaZoo, it plays very similar to Magic, which is why I likened it to an unset, because it's got these goofy mechanics, and it also kind of just plays like Magic. Light Elemental, that reminds me of like a old Magic art kind of. Poltergeist, yo, I like the little skeleton dude. Not gonna lie, I like it. Index. This must be the only non-aura page you contract this turn. Search your spellbook for a beastie page, place it into your hand, and then that's pretty good. It's like a tutor. Got another blob, got another Dover Demon. Boogeyman. This is an uncommon Boogeyman. Then we have a Thunderbird. That's pretty cool. Good old Midwestern legend, Thunderbird. Shadow Token, just on Route 66. Just a little blobby shadow. Coming out in the daylight. Probably not the best time to come out if you're a shadow, to be TBH. TBH. I know there's a Mothman in this set, and the Mothman was like the big money card of the last set. So maybe we'll get a Mothman. Destroy Aura. We have a Land Tax. Shout out to Magic the Gathering players. Imprisonment, that looks kind of cool. What is this? The Columbia River Sand Squink. Okay, I have to look this up because I live by the Columbia River. I'm from Oregon, so I'm not sure about the Sand Squink. I have to look up, like, what is the Sand Squink? This is a Grafton monster, big old chonky boy. This is a reverse holo rare. Ooh, okay. Grim Reaper. I would like a full holo Grim Reaper because that looks awesome. Like, I dig that quite a bit, actually. I know a lot of people are very, what's the right word? Divisive on the artwork. And I can see it. I can see it. I understand. But sometimes this just looks awesome. Kind of like a metal album cover. I dig it. Yeah. So I understand the divisiveness. Also, actually also think that the divisiveness really works in favor of MetaZoo, Static One, because it gets people talking about it. Jack-o'-lantern. This, the artifact pumpkin. Artifact pumpkin. All right, that's what that is. We have a banish, Spectre Moose. Ooh, is this another? Oh, ooh, okay, hold on. So this is a Qualbalik. Yep. This is Indrid Cold. This is like, he's another legend, like a folklore, you know, local legend kind of thing. Urban legend. He's like a creepy dude. He's just a creepy dude. So that's pretty cool. It's a reverse holo Indrid Cold. We have Momo. I like these cool dark cards because my favorite MetaZoo deck that I have three MetaZoo decks built and ready to play. And my favorite one is my dark deck. My dark deck. This is the axe-faced dude. This is Garbage Town Tunnel Monster. smoky spirits. Yeah, a little smoke them out. We got a Holy Eyes. Interesting. Nightshade. Ooh! Full foil Righteous Reckoning. Destroy. Okay, this is a sweet one. Okay, it says destroy all fatigued beasties. Each caster recovers 25 life point for each of their non-token beasties. Destroy this way, blah blah blah. End your turn after resolving this page effects. That's pretty sweet. That's a good card. We need more cards like that. For like all of the colors. Because this one's specifically light. It'd be good to have board wipes for all of the colors. Or just ways to have removal for all the colors. Because I played in games where like my opponent got, you know, a really early lead by playing some, you know, a couple early powerful beasties. And even though I was able to deal with them, they just kept playing them. And there's no way for me to come back because there was no board wipes in the game. We have a Prism Beam. Yo, this is pretty cool. It's like the opposite of the Death Beam. Equip this page to an aura page in the arena. Equip page is now in light aura and generates an additional light aura upon generating aura. Okay, weird card. Not exactly what I thought it would do. It's like a resource generating card. River of Time. Take another turn after this one. What? This is a 5-cost card. You take another extra turn. Or just take an extra turn. Well, there's definitely some spicy stuff in this set. That's probably another one. Another good one to get in full foil. So I guess the full foil ones that I want, Indrid Cold, the, whatchamacallit, Grim Reaper. So Indrid Cold, Grim Reaper, and the take an extra turn card. Ildiyama Lake Monster. I read Llama Lake Monster. I don't even know how to pronounce that. Index, Holy Eyes, Veggie Man. What is this dude? Potion Seller. Is this a reference to like a video game? Potion Seller? This is a weird one. He's like Potion Shop. Once per turn, place a potion for each from your cemetery. Opposing casters may use this page's power. Oh, this is a weird card. I think it's cool though. This weird potion dude gets potions and lets your opponent use the potions. Is this Born from the Earth is rare? Hold on. I've been putting that in the common pile. Oh no, we have a couple of them just kind of sitting in here. So while I do this, let's just chat a little bit about MetaZoo. I know there's a lot of negativity about MetaZoo. A lot of it stems from the absurd prices of the game, and I understand, honestly. It was hard for me to come across this box at all. I likely would not have even had this box if it weren't for Channel Fireball, just to be, you know, completely honest. So. Yeah, I understand. It's like hard for me to get it too. Like I'm a content creator and I make videos about card games, a lot of indie card games, mostly Flesh and Blood, but you know, I've made MetaZoo videos before because I think it's a fun, goofy little thing. And the fact that it was hard for me to get the boxes says a lot, so I understand. But if you can get the boxes at a good deal at your local game store, and you like the art and you like the flavor and you like the cryptids and you like the goofiness, I say go for it. It's fun. Like it's just a fun thing. Like I'm having a ton of fun opening these cards and looking at all of like the absurdity. And I'll likely make some weird decks with these and, you know, play with my friends who play this. There's a couple other content creators who play this. The iceberg, a little Loch Ness monster there. What is this fire dog? Tikaler. Yep, Jack-o'-lantern bomb. Anyway, I It's fun and I recommend it. There's another prism beam. There's a second prism beam. There's another whoop-de-woo monster dude. There's a Suburban. That's kind of cool. Are they doing trick-or-treat? They are doing trick-or-treat. Look at that. Look at that. We need to scoot these over. We have an abundance of cards and not an abundance of space. We're getting a lot of like full hollows here. We're not even like halfway through. Oh, I need to hurry up. We're not even halfway through the box. All right, let's speed this up. We'll speed this up. Messing up opening the packs is not a good way to do the speedy up. It's a good way to get the slowy down. So we'll skip through a lot of the Bubbling Brew. We'll skip through a lot of the cards we've already seen before. Whoa, oh, that is metal. That is so metal. Unholy Fire. Dude, what is this? The Bandage Man of Cannon Beach. Cannon Beach? I feel like I've been to Cannon Beach. Bell Witch. That's kind of cool. So this is a reverse holo foil. Look at that Cosmic Aura. Just dude floating in space. Dude floating in space. Yeah, so any of the people out there watching this, have you actually played MetaZoo, given it a shot? What? Water to Wine. Why is he wearing a rainbow smock? I don't know, Poltergeist. They probably want to avoid like religious things, but Zombie Apocalypse, we have this reverse dude and the Alaskan Vortex. What is that? It's the Gigi Bird just vortexing it up. Got these Zombros. Zombie Apocalypse, does this kill all the dudes? Replace all beasties in the arena with fatigued zombie tokens. Yo, that's sweet. That is sweet. That's a much needed card too. So yeah, it looks like there are more board wipes, which is good. Like, you definitely need more board wipes. Yeah. I honestly, like, one of my favorite ways to play the game is just like half health. Just half health, because they're so like, take so long. Grafton Monster, reverse. We have another Bell Witch. We have another Sandwich. It's not actually a sandwich. The guy's getting eaten like you would eat a sandwich. Well, I don't know who eats sandwiches like that. I mean, like, can you imagine eating a sandwich like that? oh, dude. I'm trying to imagine someone eat like a hoagie like that. You know, the big booty guy. Just calling him booty guy now. Ooh, I see some things. I think we might have some spice. Do we have the all spice? Oh, it's another Grim Reaper. Ah, oh, it's still reverse. No, it costs 9 to play. Holy boosh. We have a boil over and a shadow. Oh, that's cool looking. A full moon. It's gotta be done. Is it art by Poncho? That is art by Poncho. Poncho's the dude who did the art on this mat. Did I put that Grim Reaper in the wrong spot the first time? Is it a reverse holo in the non-holo pile? Maybe. Maybe. Do I care all that much? Kind of not really. Good old brain in a jar. Vampire, like the vampire lady. We have, this is a reverse holo. Beast of Bladenboro. That's a reverse holo common. Jack Frost, that's kind of cool. Good old Jack Frost. And then we have got a lot of explosive things. A lot of explosive things. It's not a huge set. There's only 163 cards in the set. So, honestly, there's not a lot of, you know, options. At some point, we'll probably see everything, though I don't think we'll get one of each of the rares here. Whoa, have not seen that. That looks rad. Like, Sinister Shadows? That actually looks cool. Reminds me of, like, a Newgrounds kind of thing, like, from back in the day. Unlucky Potion. We have a reverse axe head. This is a non-foil Indrid Cold. And then Zombies in the City. Zombies in the City. We're getting there. We still got some packs. This is a fun set to open. I imagine like there's probably not a value open, like not a ton of value opening a lot of these, because it feels like I'm getting a lot of these commons and stuff. Though I've not seen this. Holy Bloodlust. That's a brutal Chupacabra. Torrential River. This is a Quablek. We have a reverse holo. That guy again. The Old Books, Crying Trees, Crying Blood. Brutal. And then we're getting a lot of these just like Munch the Dude tokens. Munch the Dude tokens. All right, yeah, so I mean, like, if I'm like, oh, I wanna call cards to get, we still have not seen the Mothy Man, the Man of the Moths. So I guess that's brutal. Bloody Bones, Bloody Bones. Caster Center MD, there's a bunch of stuff we haven't seen yet. I take that back. Robert the Doll, what are these cards? We have another Reverse Holo, this zombie guy, and then a Permafrost. That is just very, very frosty. Stay frosty, stay frosty. All right, so the box was pretty top loaded with those foils, right? Because we have not hit a foil in a while, I feel like. Or maybe it was like just one, but not a lot. Ooh, there's another Wendigo. It's a reverse Wendigo. There's another Jeroni. There's a reverse Wendigo. Not as good as the full Wendigo. We have another Dark Watchers. Another thing to note, and I've mentioned this a couple times, is how many of the card you can have in your deck. So like this card, this Prism Beam, you'll have one per deck. So getting one, you got it. You're there. But some of the cards are like, you can have like eight in your deck, and you're like, well, I need a lot of those. So the rares that you can have a lot of in your deck are kind of annoying to get. Whereas some Mermaid's Shimmer, I think that's the first time we've seen that common, or that is a common. Which is lightning. Oh, what is this? I don't think I've seen this one. Crazy Critter of Bald Mountain. Maybe we have. Crazy Critter of Bald Mountain. That's a common. Divine Covenant. That's, I'm not even gonna comment on what's going on there. They're just going in real close. Going in real close. all right. I was gonna say try to keep this family friendly, but I mean, like, it's hard to keep it family friendly when you got this. This dude getting eaten like a hoagie. That's gonna be the new thing. Just eating like a hoagie. Got a bubbling brew. Got a Specter Moose. Oh, we got another rare. It's a full foil. Stalactites. We got another Alaskan Vortex. That is a plate. Oh, dude, that looks cool. The Dusk. I dig it. Yeah, I forgot what I was saying. I don't know, I was talking about the stalactites or something. I don't know. We got a, this is me now. I'm just like, there's the words coming out. We have a Cosmic Warp, this eyeball. We have another Goku. It could be Vegeta. Oh, Trunks. It's Trunks. We got the Bioluminescence, got a vampire, Marceline, the Vampire Queen. I have so many of this guy. He's reverse holo. You can only have one on your deck, and I have a bunch of them. We got another Momo, fuzzy purple monster. The Pale Moon, or Full Moon. I like Pale Moon. Pale Ale. I could go with the Pale Ale right now. I could go with the Pale Ale. Good old IPA. Man, I live in Portland. There's some good stuff out there. I have not seen this. Frostbite, Skullhead. I have not seen this. What is this weird tongue thing? Tuttle Bottoms Monster. All right. Caster Center MD, you got the Dover Demon. We got this crazy thing. Oklahoma Octopus. People from Oklahoma, is this a thing? Like, look at the little tiny island. Brutal, what? We got two of them. All right, we got a good one, then we got like the opposite. How many can you have in your deck? One per spell book. Well, I got the shiny one. There's the shiny one. Yeah. So it's interesting. It's interesting. You see that duplication a lot here. You see another card here. Do we get? Whoa! What is this? I thought it was gonna be. By the way, we got this weird vortex thing. Dispel evil. That totally looks like the evil capture wave thing from Dragon Ball. Anyway. You got this freaking Space Odyssey obelisk. It's a full foil, so okay, we got two obelisks. Hey, look, two per deck. There you go. Playset acquired. Playset acquired. What does the freaking obelisk even do? What does the obelisk even do? You can fatigue this page. Oh, this is the essence. So it makes an earth and a dark. I gotcha. So if you're making like a dark earth one. I want an alien dark one, thank you very much. The dark and the aliens. Cause I want to make some alien stuff happen. All right, so They got this weird tongue thing. Tuttle bottom. Good old Tuttle bottom. Zombie apocalypse. Ooh, Lightning Alley. Oh, that's cool. That's real cool. There's a 2 per spellbook. Do we have another Lightning Alley behind the lightning? Ah, that is a Jack Frost. All right, we got a couple more packs left. We're getting to the end. I don't think there was a box topper in this one. Right? All right. Nope. I guess there's not any box toppers. I don't know. All right, we're just gonna keep going. So I have to go look and see what the secret rare is, because I don't know. Is it the red ghost? It can't be the red ghost. Is it the red ghost? It is 17. No, it's not the red ghost. All right. Well, anyway, let's continue on. Oh, here's that little monster. Maybe we passed it before. I don't think I've seen this one. There's still some we haven't seen. Exquisite Brew or Stew. That is just Marilyn Manson album. What is this? Lightning Split. Look at that shimmer. That looks nice. And then the foiling looks nice. And then we have Abduction. What? This is our first Abduction. It's a weird thing to say, but that's that. All right, still a lot of cards we haven't seen yet, apparently. Very interesting. That pyre is brutal. Absolutely brutal. Get the mud. We got another potion seller. What is this? Unlucky potion and then a potion seller. We gotta hawk some potions. And then we have a non-foil prism beam. All right. I wonder, so in the first set, there were some cards that were always foil no matter what, that you could not get non-foil versions of, like the Death Beam, for example, or the Chessie. There's a bunch of them. And what is this? Black-Eyed Children, 10 per spellbook. This is the first one of these we've gotten. What is this? There's a bunch of this stuff that we haven't gotten. Great Blizzard? We have another Marceline, and then, wait, we have another foil Prism Beam. This is our third one, and then we have a Righteous Reckoning, and then some little spoders and a thing. Okay. All right. We got two more packs. Yeah, two more packs. All right, so we gotta get a Mothman. Like, we gotta get the man of the moth. Not a cloth man. I don't know why I opened this up so weirdly. But a Mothman would be cool. I honestly don't know the value, so I just wanna, I gotta see the Mothman. Mothman, no, this guy. Columbia, oh, it's the squink. And then the Bellwitch, okay. Okay, we got one more chance. We got one more chance. Chance at glory. Here we go. This is gonna be a really, really long video. I hope you enjoyed the ride here. It's been fun for me. It's been weird. And it's always interesting checking out a new set, especially when it's like this crazy. I do like the little trick-or-treating monster. Okay, so we did get a rare foil. What is it? Oh, it's another red dude. All right, our third red ghost, and then a boil over. Okay. That's a reverse. Well, that was weird. I think we got some cool stuff. I don't know, once again, I don't know, like, the value of these, but I like the Wendigo. The Wendigo is cool. I dig the Wendigo. Also, have you played... Well, I don't want to spoil the game. Never mind. There's a cool horror game that has Wendigos in it. Yeah. That's our MetaZoo Nightfall box opening. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Thank you for taking the time to watch this far. If you've watched this far, I don't know. Say, it sounds derogatory. Squink? Say squink. Got a little boogeyman too. All right, anyway, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time.